In preparation for selecting your courses for the next school year, we are going to review the graduation requirements. You will also be learning how to read a transcript and complete your credit checklist. We'll be going through the process step by step to help you choose your classes wisely.
First, let's review the State of Hawaii graduation requirements brochure. You have a copy in your STARS Google Classroom to refer back to later. The table on the left outlines the various requirements for graduation. To the right of the table, there is an explanation for the various certificates you can earn beyond the basic high school diploma. We will now go over all the different parts separately.
Looking at the table on the left, English is the first category. You must earn 4 total credits. You may notice that the table and the brochure only list 2.5 specific credits. In brief, you can earn the 4 credits by passing your grade 9, grade 10, grade 11, and grade 12 English classes. When we look at registration forms during the next STARS, we will look closely at the option for grade 11 and grade 12 English. For now, just be aware that you need to earn 4 credits in English. If you didn't pass an English class, you will need to retake it. Social studies also requires 4 credits, with specific credits earned in World History, 1 credit, US History, 1 credit, Modern History of Hawaii, half credit, and Participation in Democracy, half credit. For your senior year, you get to choose from several social studies courses. As with the English classes, a failed social studies course will need to be taken again. Let's plan to pass every class the first time you take it.
Only 3 credits are required for math, 2 of which must be Algebra 1 and Geometry. However, if you are planning to attend college, you should take a 4th year of math to be better prepared for the math classes that will be required to earn your degree. Yes, even English majors are required to take math in college. Science requires 3 credits as well, with 1 being in biology. Once again, if you are planning to attend college, it is strongly recommended that you take a 4th science course in your senior year. Once again, even non-science majors are required to take science courses at college.
This next category can sometimes be confusing, but I'm here to walk you through it. You must earn 2 credits in any one of the following categories: World Language or Fine Arts, or Career and Technical Education, otherwise known as CTE, or JROTC. In World Language, the 2 credits must be in the same world language, such as Hawaiian 1 and Hawaiian 2, Spanish 1 and 2, or Japanese 1 and 2. Same for CTE. The 2 credits must be in the same pathway, such as Public and Human Services, Pathway Class, and Culinary 1. For Fine Arts, you can mix and match the credits you want, such as taking General Art and Dance, or you can take 2 years in a single area, such as Ceramics 1 and 2. For JROTC, you can meet this graduation requirement by taking 2 years of JROTC. Again, this graduation requirement means you can earn 2 credits in one of these areas, not in all 4. Stay with me, people. We are almost done reviewing the graduation brochure. 1 credit in PE is obtained with half credit in PEP 1005, 9th grade PE, and a half credit in a 10th grade PE course of your choice, such as physical fitness, lifetime activities, individual and dual sports, or swimming. People, if you sign up for swimming, please be sure you are willing to swim, even if the class is first thing in the morning. If not, choose something else. Please be aware that weight training and team sports do not meet the PE graduation requirement, but they do count for general electives, which we will discuss in a moment. Health today and tomorrow, generally taken in your 10th grade year, fulfills the half credit in health.
Woohoo! Electives! Finally, the section where you get to have more choices. 6 elective credits are required. Please be aware that there are, in addition to the 2 electives in a world language, fine arts, CTE path, and JROTC.
And finally, a half credit for your personal transition plan, PTP, is earned when you successfully complete your PTP. Yes, the PTP is a graduation requirement at any public high school in the state of Hawaii. My young friends, it is not something we just dreamt up to keep you from enjoying life. When you add all these credits, you get a total of 24. Before we take a brief brain break, one more item we need to discuss: honors recognition certificates. These show that you have gone above and beyond the basic graduation requirements. If you plan on having a cumulative GPA of 3.0 or above, please be sure to read the requirements specific to each certificate. In addition to the certificate, students who earn this recognition traditionally receive an awesome cord to wear at commencement, making the ceremony extra special for them and their families.
For the next part of today's lesson, you'll be learning how to read your transcript, as you can see on the slide. It provides necessary information to help you choose your classes for next school year. Your counselor has sent you an email with your transcript attached. You'll be using it later in the lesson to complete your credit checklist. For now, we will be going over each part of the transcript so you can see how it will help you choose your classes wisely. This is what a typical transcript looks like. Your transcript may have more courses listed in the left column, depending on your grade level.
Let's look at the various parts of a transcript. At the top of the page, you will find your demographic information, including your name, date of birth, and student ID number. The bottom portion of your transcript shows all of the courses you have taken. They are grouped by the year the courses were taken, along with the title of the course, ACCN number, grade, and credit earned. The total credits earned at the end of the year is also indicated. For registration purposes, you will want to pay special attention to the course title, letter grade, and credit earned. The credit summary column can be a bit confusing at first glance. The rec column shows which courses and credits are required for graduation. The comp column shows which credits you've already completed. The ink column shows which credits you still need to earn. The very bottom shows you your total credits earned as well as how many more you need to graduate. Remember, in order to be promoted to the next grade level, one must earn a minimum of 5 credits for the 10th grade, 11 credits for the 11th grade, and 17 credits for the 12th grade. Ultimately, a total number of 24 specific credits are needed to graduate and earn a high school diploma.
Using the graduation requirement checklist, you will be able to analyze your transcript to see if you are on track for graduation. This is also a key step in preparing to choose your classes for next school year. Please follow the steps as we go through them, so you understand how to complete each part. Just as a reminder, this form is a requirement for your PTP. So after today's STARS class, you will have completed one PTP requirement, as well as gotten a good start on preparing to choose your classes.
The first part is English. As mentioned earlier, 4 total credits must be earned. Refer to your transcript and locate under your 9th grade year, English Lang Arts 1. Write in the grade and credit you've earned. For example, grade equals C, credit equals 1 under the 9th column as shown. For your current in progress classes, write in the grade and credit you plan on earning by the end of the semester for semester classes or school year for year-long classes. Now look at the social studies section. For most of you, world history and culture is taken in 9th grade. In this case, a grade of C and 1 credit were earned. Remember, for your current classes, indicate the grade and credit you plan on earning by the end of the school year.
With math, you will have taken either MOW, Alg 1, or Geometry during your 9th grade year. If you took MOW, write it in the block below Alg 2. Those of you who earned your Alg 1 credit during 8th grade, fill in both Alg 1 and Geometry under 9th grade. If you retook a failed course, then place it under the year you passed it. Math workshops counts as an elective. Do not write it in here. Now for science. If you took environmental science during 9th grade, you can edit your checklist by replacing the word physical with environmental. Please remember that you have some choice in science classes, but biology is required for graduation. As with all the categories for your current classes, put the grade and credit you plan to earn by the end of the school year.
For this category, remember that the 2 credits need to be from the same specific program of study. Freshmen, don't worry if you are not taking a world language, fine arts, CTE, or JROTC class this year. You can sign up for one when we choose during our next STARS. Sophomores and juniors, please pay close attention to this section. If you aren't sure what course you might need to take next year to meet this requirement, please contact your counselor. For PE and health, please note that the courses are worth half credit because they are semester courses. Reminder, team sports and weight training count as elective credits, not the required PE basic elective. We'll get to the elective section soon.
The half credit for your PTP will be issued the semester you complete it. Just know that this is a graduation requirement. You must successfully complete your PTP in order to earn a diploma and participate in the graduation ceremony. For those of you who have already completed your PTP, awesome! Put the letter S and 0.5. All other courses that do not fall under any category above should be listed under electives. In the example shown, transitions to high school and team sports 1/2 are listed. Math workshop and English lab classes also count as electives. If you aren't sure what category a class is considered, please contact your counselor.
Final step. For the bottom section of the checklist, please total the credits you've earned for each year. Freshmen, you will again put the total number of credits you plan to earn by the end of the school year. Sophomores and juniors, in addition to the total credits for each year, add up the total cumulative credits you've earned to be sure you are on track for meeting graduation requirements.
KVEX will be featuring various courses, so stay tuned. Keeping track of your own grades and credits will help to ensure graduation in 4 years. If you have any questions or concerns, please contact your counselor immediately.
That's the end of the presentation. You can email your counselor or reach out through the Contact a Counselor form on Hilo High's website. Thank you for watching.